The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi, welcome back to the social class. How are you all? ഈ ചോദ്യം ഡെയിലി കേട്ടിട്ട് ബോറടിച്ചിരിക്കുമായിരിക്കും അല്ലേ? ഓക്കെ, സോ ഒരു ചേഞ്ച് ആയാലോ അല്ലേ? ഒരു ചേഞ്ച് ആർക്കും ഇഷ്ടമല്ലാത്ത അല്ലേ? ഓക്കെ, സോ ടുഡേ ലെറ്റ്സ് സി ഹൗ ടു ആസ്ക് ദ സെയിം ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഇൻ ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ലാംഗ്വേജസ്. ഓക്കെ, ആർ യു ഓൾ റെഡി? യെസ്. സോ വാച്ച് ഇറ്റ്.
എല്ലാവർക്കും സുഖമല്ലേ?
எப்படி இருக்கீங்க?
ஆப் சப் கைசே?
நீவு ஹேகிதிரி?
ஹவ் இஸ் இட்? யெஸ், இட் இஸ் ரியலி நைஸ், இஸ்ன்ட் இட்? யெஸ். விச் ஆல் லாங்குவேஜஸ் டிட் யூ ஐடென்டிஃபைட்? யெஸ், தமிழ், ஹிந்தி. ஓகே, யெஸ். ஸோ டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் லாங்குவேஜஸ் இன் இந்தியா. ஓகே, take page number 89 in your studio. Indian languages. There are 22 major languages spoken by the people of India. So mainly there are 22 languages which are spoken by Indian people. Some of the languages spoken by the people of India are Hindi, Punjabi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Manipuri, Tamil, Bengali, Telugu, Malayalam, Assamese and Oriya. And which is our language? Yes, our mother tongue is Malayalam, isn't it? Yes. Hindi is the language spoken by most number of people. So Hindi is the language that's spoken by most number of people in India. Okay. And English is also a commonly spoken language in India. And English is a foreign language, but English is also a commonly spoken language in India. So Hindi is the language that's spoken by most number of people in India, but English is also used as the spoken language in India. Did you know each Indian currency note has its amount written in different languages? Observe a currency note and see how many languages you can identify. Write the number in the space provided. So you have to take a currency note. Each Indian currency note has its amount written in different languages. So you have to count it and you have to write the number of languages in a currency note in this space provided. Okay, yes. Then besides these languages, Sanskritam, also called Sanskrit, has its origins in India. So we have already said about Tamil, Telugu, Bengali, Malayalam, Hindi, English, etc., isn't it? But besides these languages, there is a language called Sanskritam. So besides these languages, Sanskritam, also called Sanskrit, has its origins in India. You will learn the language Sanskrit from UP. So it is one of the oldest living languages in the world today. So it is one of the oldest living languages in the world today. Not only in Kerala or not only in India, it is one of the oldest living languages in world, in the world today. Okay, so it is important language. Many of the Indian languages are said to have originated from Sanskrit. So many of the Indian languages has its origin from Sanskrit. So Sanskrit is the mother of many Indian languages. Okay, we can say like that, isn't it? Yes. So Sanskrit is the mother of many Indian languages. Then the great Indian epics, the Mahabharata and the Ramayana, were written in Sanskrit. So the great epics, Mahabharata and Ramayana, were written in Sanskrit. These two great epics were written in the Sanskrit language. Okay, yes. So it is one of the oldest living language in the world now, and it is the mother of many Indian languages. Okay, the village Mathur in Karnataka is known as the Sanskrit village of India. So the village Mathur in Karnataka is called as or known as the Sanskrit village in India. Why it is called so? Let's see. Sanskrit is the language that is spoken by the most people in this village. So Sanskrit is the common language that used by the people in this particular village. So that is why this village is called as the Sanskrit village of India. So which is the Sanskrit village of India? The village Mathur in Karnataka is called as the Sanskrit village. Okay. So today we have discussed about Indian languages, isn't it? Yes. So mainly there are 22 languages in India, such as Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Bengali, then Malayalam, then Hindi, etc., isn't it? And Hindi is a language which is spoken by most number of people in India, and English is also a communicate language in India. And then we discussed about the Sanskrit language, isn't it? Yes. So that's all for today. Stay happy and healthy and attend your exam with confidence. Okay. Meet you in the next class. Till then, bye.